Okay. Good afternoon. My name is Esther Soria and I'm doing my PhD in the Canary Island Institute of Astrophysics. During this presentation, I'm going to talk about the main topic of my thesis and show you the results of the first year, prototype of an adaptive optic system for intermediate-sized telescopes. To put things in context, this project born as a consequence of the success achieved for AOLI in the William Herschel Telescope. This instrument was planned as a double system to use adaptive optics and Lucky imaging. The sequence shows the closed loop performance in William Herschel, the science camera with the reference star, the decrease in the root mean square and the revealed wavefront. Since then, the design of a new instrument for intermediate-sized telescope was proposed. This can optimize those telescopes because they not usually have a predefined adaptive optic system. We were looking for a portable design to be installed in different focus. Because of that, we thought in a modular design to change only the required part. So we divide the prototype in 5 different parts: simulator calibrator for different tests in lab, wavefront corrector, wavefront sensor, control software, and science. This approach also allows us to make a comparison of different wavefront sensors in different terms, such as the atmospheric condition, the observational target of the telescope with which we work. The base of this prototype is to use resources of previous projects. At first, the instrument has been thought for 2 different telescopes, the Carlos Sánchez with 1.5 meters and the Nordic Optical Telescope with 2.5 meters. Now, I'm going to talk about the design for the Carlos Sánchez and the modules wavefront corrector, wavefront sensor, and control software. Okay, I will start with the wavefront corrector. A design as simple as possible using commercial achromatic doublet, the collimating lens, image, the entrance pupil on the DM, and then a second focus lens. The relationship between the focal length is 1-to-1 to avoid generating magnification. In the near future, this compact design allows to incorporate a tilted mirror along the optical path. In this case, we have reused the DM for the previous project. It is frontal power with 88 actuators. And for the wavefront sensor module, 3 different wavefront sensors have been proposed. For all of them, the detector camera will be the same, a IMI-CCD vacuum-illuminated camera. First of all, as a Harman, because of its simplicity and wide use, we select the simplest design. The second one is a geometric wavefront sensor known as the pupil plane. This was used in AOLI in the previous project. But in this case, we had to change the optical design because in this case, we need an instrument much more compact and small. So to generate the enough difference in the optical path between the pupils, we select a pentabris. And this optical element also allow us to avoid excessive separation of our pupils in our detector. And the last one, a pyramidal wavefront sensor, because the great results in astronomy. With this kind of wavefront sensor in our group, we don't have any experience. So for us, the pyramidal is a challenge. How the idea is to work with 3 different wavefront sensors, the input in the slope calculation program will be different. In the case of the Sar-Harman, we have to calculate the position of the exposed centron in its microring region, while for the TP3 of the pyramid, we need to do a comparison of the intensity per pixel in the region of the different pupil for later apply its algorithm. The goal is to get the same response at the output. Optically, it's much more visual work with scenic coefficients than with slopes. So we calculate this through a least square adjustment. Below, I show the process to follow to configure the control loop we have implemented. We read the Zernike coefficient, then we have the possibility of applying a binary mask in the case of, for example, not want to add on any of the coefficient. Then we select our target. It is very useful to make a characterization of the non-common path aberration of our system because in this point, we could control them. After that, we select the PI control parameters, and finally, we pass the pseudo-inverse of the influence matrix of our DM, and the response is a voltage on our DM. The CP line is going to be used for the base flat and characterization of our DM. But for that stack, we're going to use a psycho interferometer. The input is going to be the surface and the target, and the target a base flat. Finally, I want to show you a sequence, a sequence showing the closed loop in the laboratory with the Sachharman for the Carlos Sánchez with a simulated scene on 2.4 arc second. Okay, the wavefront sensor camera, the reference star, and now we close the loop, and this is the Rydmin scale, but we change the scale, and the rebuilt wavefront sensor with 66 Czernike coefficient. With this experiment, we saw that we can close the loop in really bad conditions. Unfortunately, it was planned to test the prototype in the telescope last week, but we had to delay it. But we know that through this month, we are going to have the first test on Skype of our prototype. That's all for my part. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. So if there is any question, do not hesitate.